Due to Robin contacting the other side, Kenisha has Robin's name removed from her call list at the shelter and strips her of the title, Mama Robin.
At the shelter? So if they think I'm gone too long, they're gonna blow up your phone. Oh, and I had Robin moved.
Well, that's good.
Like, I straight up had her fucking removed. She said someone called up here saying that she wanted to talk to me. I said, who? And she goes, her name is Robin. I said, remove her. Isn't she your mom? I said, was.
Yeah.
You know, the thing about that whole situation, I'll be honest, maybe I was trying to find the love I'm missing from my own mom and another person, and that was a mistake on me. But, I mean, I'm 21. I'm not some little kid. I shouldn't be getting attached to someone calling them mom, you know?
The narrative unfolds on July 31st when Kenisha makes a shocking call, alleging that her roommate was expelled from a program for falsely reporting domestic violence.
Just woke up. It got very chaotic last night. Like, so fucking mad.
Why?
Because one of the girls that were staying at the shelter here invited her boyfriend here, and he faked a DV situation. And they were put in the same room. Well, they were caught in, let's per se, the act.
Oh.
And everybody, you know, all of us, we joined together because we got sick and tired of them just letting men in here for no fucking reason that didn't need to be in here.
Yeah.
So.
Dang.
And they got kicked out.
As the investigation progresses, attention is drawn back to the restraining order filed by Kenisha, where she details incidents of physical violence.
On top of him having to be 500 feet away from me without any contact.
So, before you all want to say anything, you might want to get your facts straight.
The unsettling contradiction emerges when Kenisha had assured the police just 2 weeks earlier that Kyle had never posed a threat to her.
Okay, see, he wouldn't let you talk earlier, really Riverside, and you kind of were just like...
Yeah.
So, did he... And he hasn't touched you at all?
No.
Not one...
No.
Has he threatened
him? No.
The events of August 1st unfold with Kenisha's repeated visits to the ER, where she clashes with the ER nurses who insist that nothing is medically wrong with her.
Beth, no, you're perfectly fine, honey.
What's that?
Davis.
What's that?
Hannah. I don't know, they don't go to the second floor. I'm not from here.
Okay, what's your birth?
4:30:02. Kenisha? Oh, I don't know why they told me to go second. Where do I go when I go?
Oh,
girl, you should have, like, you should have been on the phone with me last night. So they called me, and they asked me to go back to the ER. So I was like, okay, whatever. I went back to the ER. Of course, you know, waited 4 hours, the usual, just for them to tell me, your labs are fine. No, they're not. I'm sitting there like, you should have seen her face when I said, no, they're not. She goes, and how would you know? I'm looking at them. Well, they're not low enough for concern or high enough for concern. I said, but even if that's the case, why wouldn't you tell me?
Yeah.
Why didn't you tell me about the issue with my right side on my chest? Like, you didn't tell me none of that. Oh, yeah, they didn't tell me none of that. And that's the thing, and that's why I called them out. And I did tell them, I got really shitty with them, I'm not gonna lie. I was like, if something happens to me, it's gonna fall back on you guys.
Yeah.
Like, why are you telling me to come back out here? And then tell me, oh, it's nausea. That's not even one of my symptoms. You just slapped a symptom on that fucking paper just to get me out of here.
The town's hospital staff have grown weary of her frequent and unnecessary trips to the emergency room.
Someone once again ran their mouth about me being in the fucking hospital, and I think it's fucking Felicia, and if I find the fuck out it is, I'm gonna snap. Mm-mm. Because that's the girl I was yelling at the fucking kids, and I said something.
Aww.
But this fucking hospital, I'll tell you, from everything on the holy, if something happens to me, you can quote this to the next person. I want that hospital fucking soon. Well, if I go to the doctor tomorrow and I find out it's not just something, you know, simple, that could be fixed easily, I'm gonna say something to the fucking board, because I called the hospital like 8 different times today. And they called me. Oh, they were not happy, and I wasn't either. And imagine me, no cigarettes, talking to a hospital. Like, I was so fucking mad. I was literally crying when the fucking doctor walked out. And she's like, we got your discharge papers. I said, why? I said, it doesn't surprise me, honestly. She goes, what do you mean by that? I said, I've been here so many times for the same issue. My labs are abnormal. And you're trying to tell me they're not abnormal. If I would have talked to one more person, I promise you, I would have snapped. Like, I got shitty with her, and I didn't mean to, because that poor girl wasn't her fault, but...
Yeah.
Like, as weak as I'm feeling, not being able to really hold anything down, you know, the blood in my hair and blood in my stool, the weight loss, and all this fucking bullshit... But they're all in all things, she like basically told me, you probably will have to have a scope. So you couldn't have told me that multiple visits ago? You tell me that when I get mad?
Like,
because I'm advocating for my fucking health? Like, you don't just come in here and tell me, oh, you look really pale, and then tell me my labs were fine.
I don't understand.
When I know they're not, I'm sitting there staring at them.
I don't understand why they haven't referred you to a gastroenterologist.
On that very day, Kenisha's roommate makes a life-changing discovery. She is pregnant.
So, my day has been very adventurous since I've been back.
Oh, really? Why?
Because my roommate found out she was pregnant.
Yeah, our roommate, she's definitely pregnant. That's positive. That's really positive.
Oh,
yeah, that's really positive. It's not, like, faint. There's not no, like, straight dye line. Like, it's positive.
However, the situation takes a dark turn as Kenisha hints at a possible donation scheme, claiming she would adopt the roommate's baby.
Because my roommate found out she was pregnant and asked me if I wanted to adopt her kid.
Oh, gosh.
Yeah. It's been crazy. I said I wanted to pick a position before, you know, anything goes further. You know, it's crazy. But I don't really even know what to say. I'm excited, but I'm also scared at the same time. You know, because at first she said that she wanted to have an abortion. And I was like, well, honey, I don't agree with that, but whatever you choose to do, I'll respect. She goes, well, do you want to adopt? I was like, I stood there for a minute, and I just didn't say anything. She goes, did I offend you? Did I say something wrong? I said, no. But, I mean, how would you react? She's probably going to get state insurance. I already got her prenatals today. And she went to the ER because this morning she showed me her test. I said, oh, honey, that's positive.
Mm-hmm.
She goes, no, it's not. Oh, it was a clear positive. I mean, it was just there. Like, it was noticeable. There was no denying. It wasn't like my test where it was really, really faint. Like, it was barely able to be seen. Oh, it was there. So she went to the ER because she wasn't feeling good. And they gave her some IV fluids and nausea medicine. And she was definitely pregnant. So I'm kind of excited. Now I know I really got to get my shit together.
The day spirals into chaos as Kenisha shuttles between her roommate and the office staff inciting tension and conflict among the residents.
I was telling the office yesterday about her because she acts so privileged around here. Like, and she doesn't have to do shit. It is seriously like high school all over again. The mother of the kids, she thanked me. She's like, you didn't have to stand up for my kids. I said, I know I didn't. No person is going to tell you what you can and can't do with your kids. No person is going to sit there and tell your kids that they can't eat. No, girl, you need to shut up. You need to leave these kids alone. I went to the office and finally said something. Like, I ain't that type of person to run back and be like, oh, this and this is going on, blah, blah, blah. But I've listened to it for almost a week now.
The suspense heightens on August 4th when Kenisha stuns everyone with an allegation of abuse by her shelter roommate.
So you want to hear how my morning went yesterday, why I was trying to call you? Because one of the roommates punched me. It was literally all over me saying she was brushing her teeth. Okay, the bathrooms are put in straight. The shower's on one section. There's a middle island where you can brush teeth, brush your hands, blah, blah, blah. And then there's a bathroom that's on the other side that has like a stall door, you know what I'm talking about. And she was brushing her teeth and washing her hands. I went to go in the bedroom. It's like, I looked up, I said, hey honey, I'll wash my hands and brush my teeth after you're done. Well, I don't know what flipped in her, but she just started flipping out on me. And I asked her, my roommate, she just left today though. She goes, you could have even asked her. I was like, lower your voice when you're talking to me, please. Lower your voice when you're talking to me, please. Well, she grabbed onto my collarbone. It's bruised.
Oh, damn.
Yeah. And my collarbone's completely bruised. But, and I put my hand on her shoulder and tried to shove her off, and she wouldn't get off. So, you know, I kicked her in her shin. I said, bitch, get your hands off me. And she slammed my head against the fucking wall. They were trying to force me to go to the hospital. I was like, I'm not going to the fucking hospital because I'd be forced to press charges, and I don't want to.
Adding to the intrigue, she starts a relationship with a man she met on a dating site, from whom she begins to solicit money.
Yeah, it's not me. I'm already talking to somebody. I don't know how far it's going to go because I literally just started talking to him.
So how old is he?
30. Yeah, he's 9 years older than me, but, you know, he seems really mature. And he has a job. He works construction, so. You want to hear something cool?
Yeah.
My boyfriend, he randomly sent me $50. Didn't even ask for it.
Reddit users uncover his identity and send him revealing messages about Kenisha, leading to the unsettling revelation that he himself is a registered offender. The tension escalates further as Kenisha becomes embroiled in a heated dispute with her roommate over a charger, intensifying the ongoing drama surrounding her.
And another girl has beef with another girl because I went to go get my charger back that she's had for 2 days. And she's like, don't worry, girl, I got you. I'll come with you. I was like, cool. You know, she showed me where her room was. I went in there and said, hey, can I have my charger? She's like, my phone's only at 17%. I said, you've had my charger for 2 days. I have to work tomorrow. My phone's at 13. I need my charger. And she goes, and next time, don't be sending these black N-words in there. I was like, oh, wow.
Damn.
So you're going to talk about your own call? You know, your own click like that?
No kidding.
And I'll be like, mm-mm. Oh. I finally got to the point, I said, girl, what are you staring at? She's like, you took the charger. It's my charger. It'd be a whole different ballgame if you bought it off me. If you want to give me $15 for it, though. That's what I spent on it.
Damn.
What is down?
$14.99.
August 23rd reveals the shelter has had enough of Kenisha, and her situation becomes increasingly dire. On August 25th, she makes a return to the live stream, moving in with Kyle at his ailing mother Stacy's house.
The power's out, and we don't have AC. We have fans, but it's better than nothing.
Shockingly, viewers discover a gruesome scene, 6 dead kittens in a bathroom, deceased animals chained up, a dead horse in the barn, a starving dog, and multiple diseased cats.
In the original Part 1, viewers are granted a chilling glimpse into the inner sanctum of Stacy's residence. Let us now pause and delve once more into this pivotal footage for those who may have missed its harrowing revelations.
Glittering world of TikTok, where smiles, dances, and viral challenges abound, there's a darker side hidden beneath the filters and upbeat music. This is a story of scamming, manipulation, and the heartbreaking of animals. Trigger warning, if you cannot handle the topics that we will be covering, then feel free to ignore this video. For those of you that choose to stay, you have been warned. And before we get into the video, I would like to thank Kai Fotze for allowing me to use their video footage. I appreciate their hard work and diligence to shed light on this horrible situation. Their channel will be linked in the description. Please check them out. Let me introduce you to Kenisha Davis. She is a TikTok user that has been involved in nothing short of her fair share of controversy over her TikTok career. A quick Google search of her name will take you on one of the most disturbing journeys imaginable. It will show you the sick, twisted manipulation of people that think they are helping her, but really, just fall victim to her sick games. And with TikTok being a revolving door of new users, there is an endless loop of people that fall directly into her trap. They feed right into her plans. Kenisha has had an off-again-on-again relationship with her ex-husband, Kyle Livingston. The relationship itself is a rabbit hole of accusations against one another that rivals a teenage Netflix series. As of the making of this video, Kenisha is currently living with Kyle in a home that he shares with his ailing disabled mother Stacy and his sister Allie. Kenisha and Kyle have devised a cunning plan, something that they hoped would warm the hearts of their followers. They were going to take care of Kyle's dying disabled mother. They would move in and help out. But, as Kenisha stayed in the house and was becoming unhappy, she hatched a plan to expose the conditions of the house and the condition his sick mother lived in. This is where Kenisha decided to uncover what is going on, at the what I now call the House of Horrors. Kenisha took to TikTok showing herself, Kyle, and Allie cleaning the house. This was not something they wanted to do, but instead, this was something they were forced to do.
Originally, it wasn't my mess to clean up.
It wasn't even
But we're given a certain time limit, or we're going to have nowhere to go. It was like this when I got here.
As a concerned watcher had called Adult Protective Services due to the neglect of the sick mother, it was becoming very clear that they were not there to look innocent. She had certain supporters of hers record secret phone calls about what was going on behind the scenes, and what came next is stomach churning.
What's he going on to argue now?
Oh, he doesn't want to bury the dogs. He's calling the sheriff's department. Yeah, this has been the argument all fucking day.
Why?
I don't know. At first, I was on live and I was like, hey, you know, mom said you need to bury the dogs, you know? And there is dead cats in the fucking bathroom, by the way.
Lovely.
Yeah. Six of them, mind you.
Holy good lord.
Yeah. That's what Allie was whispering in my ear. I was trying to move the phone closer so you could fucking hear it, but...
Oh, my God.
You did have all that recorded, right?
Kenisha is playing the character of just an innocent bystander. Someone who lived in a house for a month with six dead cats in the bathroom and allegedly claims to have known nothing. She allegedly claims she is not allowed in the backyard or the basement of the home. She stood out back of the house many times to smoke a cigarette mere feet away from a rotting dead dog that was chained to a tree and allegedly starved to death. As the news spread about the dead animals, people started to fill with rage and had questions that they rightfully so wanted answers to. One viewer had asked Kenisha to take the stream to the backyard. Kenisha hesitates at first, but agrees. She walked only a few feet from the back of the house and showed the entire stream a dead dog. There, lying on the ground, was what once stood a vibrant puppy filled with wonder and excitement at the return of its caring owner, was ignored, overlooked, and would eventually succumb to its awful fate.
Can you flip the camera?
I don't want to flip the camera, but...
A lot of people are saying flip the camera. Can you just flip... trigger warning for educational purposes only.
Well, I'm gonna puke. I'm sorry. I can't do it. I can't.
Well, no one, like... What is it? Can you flip the camera? Lily, I have no idea, to be honest. A recording was leaked. What the hell is that?
It is part of a dead dog. I gotta go inside. I can't do this. I'm sorry, I can't.
Oh my
Kenisha
God.
Kenisha eventually calls the sheriff and tries to convince herself that she is innocent in all this, but all she does is admit the animals have been dead since arriving at the property. Out of her own mouth, she says, they have been dead for about a month. She is just as much to blame as everyone whom turned a blind eye to those animals, the animals that look to them for food, water, and love. An animal has unconditional love for their owners. They have so much trust in them. And this is what happens when selfish people are left to that wonderful responsibility.
When were the animals dead?
They were dead when I saw.
When was that?
Because roughly a month.
So they've been, okay, so actually, by law, if then you dispose of them within 24 hours of them knowing the animals dead.
Yeah, there's one by the tree, there's one out back. Well, Kyle brought one out in a trash bag. And they were supposed to be.
What's that thing?
I didn't know that I was going to walk into the situation. I told my mother-in-law, love her to death, he's sick. He can't, he's not mobile. I have health issues myself. He's not healthy. I ended up in the yard because I couldn't breathe last night. That's, so, I wanted me to move back in. We'll move in, see if I can help out with mom. My health issues are not the greatest, so I do what I need. And something about fire, I need me to look at my truck and help out some stuff. So I'm that coaching.
I'm
and they said it's not safe for me to be breathing it in with my health issues. My mother-in-law's in, like, she can't move without assistance. So if she tries to get to walk, she's just gonna fall.
At the time of this video, I am still unsure how many animals in total are dead. This is not my usual content, and not something I enjoyed making. I made this video to make people aware of what is going on. I am asking you to share this video everywhere you can think of. You have my full permission. I am not asking you to share for me. I am asking you to share for all those animals that suffered at the hands of these disgusting beings. Share it for them. Don't let those animals die in vain.
Animal control and a rescue organization step in to rescue Max, the only surviving dog.
September is full of ER visits for both Kenisha and Stacy.
A distressing incident unfolds on September 15th as an ambulance is summoned for Stacy, who has been asleep for over 24 hours without any aid to attend to her basic needs, leading to her lying in soiled linens.
Do not argue.
No, I'm going to come to you. Take it down there. No, stop texting both of us.
What do you mean, too much detail after that? You're talking about appeal?
No, I'm not talking about what's going on in my head.
Then what?
Your mom.
Why would they yell at you before?
Not them. Her.
Oh, Allie wants to yell? I told you to shut the fuck up. She knows if she texts us again tonight, I'm gonna go down there and go off. Not yelling wise whatsoever, just talking. She knows that. Yeah, she knows I'll call her on a dumb bullshit. Yeah, that was all?
It was.
What did you say?
She said the ibuprofen needs to go in the bathroom.
One, that's ours. Two, she kicked my ass.
No, if you truly knew the situation, you would understand why I'm so upset.
You want to do that until making a back of home?
Not hungry.
You need to eat it.
I'll eat when your mom gets up. I hate everybody putting me in the Is she still blowing up your phone?
Mm-hmm.
You go down there and talk to her, babe, because I'm really not one to listen to ding, 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 no, ding, so I'm going to go down there and snap again.
Oh, you won't, because after this, we have something to do.
Huh? Please bring your sister the damn ibuprofen! I'm very agitated. Very, very agitated.
Should be reconnecting now.
I went down there several times to try to wake her up and got yelled at. I hate being put in the position where I can't even talk. Or can't even vent. Because I'm going to get yelled at.
Oh. First thing I wake up, I'm going downstairs to wake mom up.
She needs to be woke up now. She's been asleep 22 hours.
I've been trying to wake her up every fucking time. Still keep
Kyle, I've been trying to wake her up every hour on the hour since fucking 10 o'clock.
I know
you've been asleep since 5.
We both keep getting bitched out. I told Allie this. If she don't wake up in the morning when I wake her up, because I won't be nice about it if she's still doing the sleeping shit like she's doing now. I won't be nice about it. I will call Emma.
She needs to get up now, Kyle. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and say it. I'm sorry I'm on live. She hasn't eaten today. She hasn't taken a drink of anything today. She hasn't went to the bathroom. She hasn't took none of her meds. She needs to get the fuck up. But she's also diabetic. She can go into a diabetic coma anytime.
Oh, I know. It's just Alex being a stupid ass. And if next time I go down there and I try waking her up again, Allie bitches at me, I'm gonna tell her to shut the fuck up. She needs to get up. And at least do something today. I love you.
David, join my box.
I love you.
Love you too. I'm gonna go ahead and vent. And if I get yelled at, I get yelled at. David's in the box. So I don't give a fuck.
That's fine, he's in the box, but the moment.
Because she's diabetic and she hasn't ate or nothing, then she's probably in a diabetic coma. That's what Kenisha said. She's been asleep for 22 hours.
I didn't hear anything.
Wait a minute. Wait, that's not even normal.
My light's been flagged. We need to slow down, guys. We need to slow down or I'm going to lose my life. We need to chill out or I'm going to lose my life. Go ahead.
Has anybody checked her? Have you guys... Does she have a blood pressure? Have you guys checked?
I tried. Every time I go downstairs, I get yelled at.
Okay, well, let that bitch yell at you. You need to get that woman somehow.
Because I was on the phone with the person. I can't say her name. I don't want to get backlash from that. But she even heard me get yelled at. Like, for going down there. Like, she has a white film on her.
Does she want the woman to lay there and die? I mean, honestly.
Somebody's called the ambulance, like,
exactly.
Right now.
Keep the line going and go down there and go check on that woman. Fuck what the sister says and go check on her.
She's been asleep 24 hours. She's not what? Because she's got medicine she's supposed to be taking. She's not ate. She's not slept. She's diabetic. That's not right.
David.
No.
David, call 911.
David.
Call 911, David.
Please. David, you need
to call.
Baby, please stop.
And it's your sister's fault. She brought it online.
David, call.
So, not
get
hot.
Off and go call. Everybody's telling you to go call. Amber, Melissa, go call.
Because if I do something, I'll get yelled at.
If I knew the address or anything, I would call.
David, you need to call. David, you need to call or give me the address and I will fucking call.
Melissa, I'll send something to you. Check snap.
Okay. I'm serious because Kenisha, right now, if you don't go down and do anything and something happens to her, this is all
I tried, and my calls are recorded. I'm getting yelled at.
You need to get up off your butt, and you need to physically go down there, because otherwise, if something happens to her, your ass is going to go to jail. I can guarantee you. I'm not trying to be rude or anything. Who cares about the sister? Who cares about anything? If somebody is sitting there in a fucking chair dying, what? You're not doing anything.
Melissa, go look at Snapchat right now.
Let her yell. Let her yell. Do it. I'm being 100% serious. Fucking call. Or go down.
Exactly.
There.
Get her yell, because that's her mother and she's sitting there doing that. No.
And if you don't want to call, then text me the
no fighting. They're screaming.
Go down there, Kenisha, and go check on her. Fuck what that girl says and go check on her. Because you're going to go to jail. Yeah, let her yell. What is...
Take a chill pill. Let him yell. I don't care. I'm getting ready to call right now.
Exactly. Her sugar could be bottomed out. Stay online and go down.
I'm not
going
to call. Kyle's
calling.
Alligator dumb bitch.
Kyle's calling. Finally. Okay. It only took all fucking day.
No,
Ella
being a dumb bitch.
Who cares if she's being a dumb bitch?
Hey.
This is about somebody's life.
No, let me call.
Kyle calling.
If David calls, she's gonna, once they get here, they will be recorded. So I'm calling.
Okay, then somebody call. Who cares who calls? Just somebody call.
Who gives a shit who's calling, Kyle? Somebody needs to call. Your mom's been asleep 22 hours. That's not normal. You want me pissing me all you want. This ain't about us. This is about your mother.
Kenisha all day. When I hopped on live earlier, everybody kept asking me what was wrong. That was what's wrong. That's what's wrong. That every time I fucking go down there and say something, I got told I was overreacting.
Well, then, I mean,
she obviously don't know when somebody's laying there and hasn't been awake.
I understand her not feeling good. I understand she's asleep.
Use the bathroom.
She's
eat,
not medicine
drink,
she's supposed to take.
Kenisha, go take your diet, your machine, and go check her blood sugar.
Go check her blood sugar. Who cares what Allie says?
Go check her blood sugar now.
He's calling somebody. I'm getting ready to call somebody else. I'm getting ready to make
a second.
Call.
She's been asleep 22 hours.
And she hasn't really been coherent, so.
Yeah, go check her blood sugar now.
52.
Damn, Ryder, you just chucked that at me.
52.
Make sure you put in the comment your entertainment purpose only. Do not get entered.
It is not normal for a person to sleep for 22 hours.
No, it's not. You're going to go to jail. You are going to go to jail. And Kenisha, if something happens to your live, go to Facebook. Kenisha, if something happens to your live, go to Facebook Live.
Yeah, you put everything to do. It's a shit and deal with. Now you guys see it.
Kenisha, did you hear me?
Mm-hmm.
If something happens to your live, go to Facebook Live.
I have it on.
Need I need to go screen. Check her sugar. Did you check her sugar?
I think she's doing it right now. She's checking his eye, or she's checking her blood sugar.
They can't get her awake.
They can't get her awake, sis. They tried it. They've been trying all day.
Fuckheads don't understand.
That's Allie going off.
They are not coming in that fucking door. You stay the fuck away.
What is wrong with Allie? Like, does she not care that woman hasn't been awake for 22 hours?
David, David, have you called? David, have you called?
They're going to kick us out of here because we're caring for them.
Then let them have to pick up.
David, have you called?
Right now. I don't care if you get fucking banned.
Alex, shut the fuck up.
You didn't put your fucking bullshit in there.
It's all recorded, so they're gonna obviously say that Allie doesn't care.
Can they say what?
David, did you call the cops?
I called.
Going upstairs.
Damn fucking business.
Allie is going off, sis. Allie is snapping hell. She says she's not going to let nobody in that house.
David.
As we do call the cops.
David. Have you called? I need a phone number. I don't know what fucking town they are in.
And they will put her in handcuffs if she don't shut up and sit down.
Melissa, I sent it to you.
I know, but I don't know what town. What? Okay, hold on.
Just give them the address and tell them Indiana.
Okay, I'll be back.
What time did she go to bed last night?
That's what I'm trying to figure out. Kenisha, Kenisha paused.
She's lagging really bad.
They said she's been asleep for 22 hours.
Yeah, she's been asleep for 22 hours.
3:30 yesterday afternoon. 3:30 this morning?
Yes, 3 a.m. this morning.
3 a.m. this morning. She's been asleep since 3 a.m. this morning. So she's been asleep for... since 3 a.m. And that's almost 10 a.m. It's almost 10 o'clock. So
Melissa is calling. Melissa is calling, y'all. She's calling.
Yeah, and it's almost 10. And it's almost 10 p.m. now.
The cops and the ambulance should have done been called. That woman been sleeping way too long. She's diabetic. She should have done been gone to the hospital.
Yeah, she should have.
She should have been gone, not just y'all saying that she's getting y'all getting yelled at. Fuck that. Kayla said, make sure the cops know that the sister is combative and won't let them in the house.
Okay. Give me a second.
Yeah, they need to figure out that Alex went off and saying she can refuse to let people in the house. And
said her sister's probably the one that gave her too much damn medicine. She want to act like that.
Fucking cry. I knew this was going to happen. I've been warning her. I tried to warn her, and I tried to warn her.
Who gives a shit about the living conditions? Who gives a shit? I'm sure they'd be helping homeless people, you know, bad. Who gives a shit?
Who gives a damn what that house looks like? But watch what exactly. Right now. That woman is Stacy getting the help she needs right now.
Is Sean out there?
Sean's not there. Sean's not been there. Sean left before even Kyle moved in.
David, is there any way you could... Kenisha, you're lagging really, really bad. Really bad. You're lagging really bad, Kenisha.
Huh?
What profile is Kyle using?
On Facebook? I have no idea. He's got me blocked, so I have no idea which one he's using.
Kenisha, what's going on?
I'm upstairs.
What?
Did you check her blood sugar?
This woman's going to make sure you fucking do something.
They got not.
Did you check her blood sugar?
Kenisha, let me into my other account.
She said she wouldn't let me near her.
Who gives a fuck? Fuck that bitch!
Who gives a fuck at this point? Does Kyle got an ambulance coming?
Yes.
I got your Aunt Jackie on the phone, Kyle. She is pissed the hell off right now, especially at your sister. Your Aunt Jackie just heard everything your sister did.
What happens every time?
Sally, Melissa is calling. Melissa's calling right now as we speak.
Your sister.
Is she breathing? Is the real question. Is she breathing?
Yeah, she's breathing.
Kyle, you need to go check her blood sugar. Don't give a fuck what she says. You need to go check her blood sugar.
I don't know why your sister's been like that. There's no reason for Allie to be like that.
No,
she needs to worry about anything else but your
mom
right
now. And all the fucking stuff inside the house is on how pissed she got me. And I'm not trying to get a battery charge.
Well, I understand that, Kyle. I completely understand where you're coming from.
Yes, but Kenisha. I don't know if she'll let you touch her, but go up to her and put two fingers on her wrist and try and see if she has a pulse. Try everything. Look at everything. Figure out everything.
And your Aunt Jackie said you better do it. You better go down there and check and make sure your mom's breathing and check her pulse. And that's coming from Aunt Jackie. She said, don't worry about what you're doing. Put your sister out of your mind. Just completely ignore your sister and just check on your mother.
Kenisha, when the ambulance gets there and the cops get there, you walk up to them and tell them what is going on with the sister. David, hold on. Kenisha, when they get there, walk out there and tell them about the sister. She's being combative, will not let y'all touch her, will not let y'all do anything. Tell them that she also said that she will not let them in the house, too. Let them know all that.
If she's been that combative, they'll put your sister in cuffs.
Yeah, you need to let them know that.
And if you guys don't want to be putting cuffs right along, you've got to cooperate.
But the cops and the ambulance should have done been called hours ago.
They can be arrested for that.
Yeah, they can. They can be arrested for neglect.
Y'all can all be arrested for neglect, not just the sister, all of y'all.
Man, all right,
Melissa's on the phone with them now.
Hi, baby.
It's not
all right, then go downstairs.
They won't let him in.
I'm not going out the back door.
Do what?
I messaged Rick and told him what was going on and told him he needed to be on the highway and I needed to back her down.
What did he say?
Hey, who else is in the box? I'm bagging some stuff up at the store, so give me just a second.
David, read Cece's comment. I meant Kiki, shit.
Cece's comment.
Message yet.
David, is Jackie her power of attorney?
No. What that would be her husband. And she, and Jackie just messaged her husband.
Everybody, she's screaming again.
You don't need to change of address.
I didn't even tell him to call. But the matter of fact that, Mom, yes, I was worried. You haven't been up all day. You haven't eaten. You haven't drinking anything.
You're trying to hurt yourself since no one fucking listens to me. Maybe I ought to be the one to leave so y'all can fucking do that where you are.
Get out of my face.
I'm not even here. Right here.
Kenisha, is she awake now? Yeah.
Now she's awake. Now she's awake. So, this was so much fun. Hey. I love the original audition. So you step it up. Only two can go through. I think you're going to get the vote for that. And this also proves to all people that a young man alone in a dark room can have so much fun with just his hands. So what's going on?
Let me go again.
Please stop. This is baby.
Okay, so the mother, they're on TikTok Live. The sister's being combative, and the mother, they're saying, is dying.
Yeah, she's been
for 22 hours.
Yep. She's got health problems. They're taking care of her, and
is Kenisha, is Casey mad?
She's diabetic,
all the ambulance, or
it's
what?
It's very serious. Like, they've been on there quite a bit.
She's mad at Kyle. She's not mad at me. She's mad at Kyle. He's been sleeping since 5, and I've been the one up worrying.
She's mad at Kyle. What?
The sister's mad at me. She's not mad at me, but the sister's mad at me because I told.
Ambulance is on the way. They're on the way.
What is Stacy saying?
Well, if she woke up, that's great. Then they can see everything that's going on.
I guess she's awake now, finally. But she's mad at Kyle for something.
Well, you know what? I'm sorry. If she can be mad, they can be mad.
Kenisha, you need to get outside so you could talk to them.
Yeah, before she does. And you need to let them in the house.
Yeah, you need to make sure they get in the house and check her out. I don't care how mad Stacy gets. Let them in the house and make them check her out. I don't care. You're not doing this to be mean. You're doing this to make sure she's okay. Because sleeping that long, that much, and her not being able to wake up is not normal.
No, especially if you're not sitting there checking her blood pressure or blood sugar and everything else through it.
And you can tell her. You can tell her sister Jackie even said that. Jackie even called herself and tell her that.
No, and they have tried all day to make you up. Yeah, Jimmy isn't even in the box anymore.
Lily needs to stop. She ain't making this in situation any better with the screaming and yelling.
Yeah, Kenisha, once they get there, I would end the live.
As soon as she's awake, says, I'm going to let you go. Try to call Stacy.
Melissa, is she still in the box with you? Because it's showing me she's not in the box.
I don't see anybody in the box.
Okay, Tammy's not in the box.
Because all she's doing is that.
Mute yourself, please.
If they start their shit and they run her health in the ground because they want to start their shit, they're yelling, they're screaming, they're arguing and shit like that, I told her that I was going to come out there and I will knock their fucking heads together because I'm not going to deal with that. That's my sister out there and I'm not going to help her dead because
I don't know. I did all I can do, so I'm going to go.
Right now, it's not really not Kenisha. It's Allie.
Yeah, I know. And
so I'll let you go so you can try to call her and figure out what's going on. Just keep me. I'm going to try to stay on this live as much as long as she can stay on live. Just let me know what's going on. Cause I know you can get through to her better than I can.
I can try. They don't like to listen to me either.
So, and I know you tried to call Rick, so maybe two of you.
He's not even on Facebook. He's not looking at my message. I don't know what he's doing.
She just don't get it. We're looking out for her health, and it's like she's not.
Yeah, I know. If I have to, I'll tell her, you know, I'm the one, you know, that agreed that an ambulance needed to be called because you were not responding. You were not waking up.
Yeah, me, you.
Can you hear me, Bob?
Yeah. So. But, all right, Stace, I love you, and I will talk to you soon.
Alrighty, I'll call her.
Alright, bye. A kiss. Say bye, Aunt Jackie. You don't hang up.
I'm not going on even getting clean. Oh. I told Ellen she needs to shut the fuck up, quit yelling, or I'm living in handcuffs.
Hey, Kyle.
What?
Your Aunt Jackie's getting ready to call your mom. I just got off the phone with her. She's getting ready to call your mom herself. She is not happy with your sister at all right now. Because she even agreed that the ambulance and shit need to be called because her not being, you guys not being able to wake her up for the last 22 hours. Your mom can be pissed. That's fine. This ain't about being mad. This is about her health.
Maybe in jail, her sleeping
that hard is not even normal.
Maybe Aunt Jackie could explain that, but she just gave us 30 days to get out. Which means, babe, look at me. Look at me. As soon as you get your check, she ain't getting shit.
Shit. Kyle, listen to me. I know you're not mad at you. I know you pissed off me. You hate me and all this other shit. But for once, please just listen to me for a minute, please. Listen to me for a minute. Your mom's pissed. Your mom's not in the right mind right now. Give her time to calm down. And that's fine. She can be mad. You're not doing this to harm her. You're doing this to help her. You guys been trying to wake her up since how long? You guys did the right thing by calling 911. Point blank. Your Aunt Jackie said the exact same thing. Because what would have happened if you guys wouldn't have been able to get woke up just now? And she would have sat there and continued to sleep. Because she could have laid there, and she could have laid there longer and wouldn't have died by the coma and died. You guys would have never known it. So you did the exact right thing. Hell, I would have done it hours ago if I couldn't have got her woke up. So you did the right thing. And your sister in back now screaming and hollering the way she was. For what? The hell is she so pissed off about? Because she's trying to control the situation and she'd rather let your mom sit there and lie there and not wake her up and end up her end up passing away? Instead of making sure she's okay? That's not in any way, shape, or form cool. Or right. Because I'm telling you right now, if that's what would have happened, every single one of you would have went to jail. Point blank. All three of you would have went to jail. Because it's that's called involuntary manslaughter. Because you guys would have, that's neglect of a dependent, that's neglect. Sometimes, I can't remember, neglect something. It's also called manslaughter. You all would have went to jail. Plain and simple. So you did the right thing. No matter how you want to slice it, how you want to look at it, you did the right thing. So your mom and your sister both can be pissed off all they want.
We did the right thing, but they're making it seem like we feel like we did it.
And people on Reddit, like, I know they're listening to this, and I don't give two shits right now. Yes, we don't get along. The three of us right now that's on here can't stand each other. I get that. But at this point in time, that's not about us. It's about your mother. And for once, you guys actually did the right thing. Granted, a little bit later than what you should have, but you actually did the right thing. You should have called hours ago, but you actually did the right thing. So like I said, your mom and your sister can be pissed off all they want.
I'm pretty sure one of them
called 911. Cops are here.
Let them in. Let them in. Is Amleth with them?
You need to go downstairs. I ain't going downstairs. I can't take her yelling. I'm not going to be able to do it.
I'm not going downstairs. I'm home.
Is Amleth with them?
I don't know. Looks like the Amleth, honestly.
Maybe a cop. I wonder if the EMS comes
out. One of you guys going to have to go down and let him in because you know your sister and your mom is not going to let him in. One of you guys are going to have to go let him in.
I have to use the bathroom to come down there with me. I have to pee anyway. She's like, if I can't take any more yelling, she's going to throw me into a fucking seizure. I'm not even playing.
Why are you okay?
I'm fine.
Really? God damn it. Yeah, my glasses just broke. Are you serious? Thank God I got my backups.
What? Always on scratches?
He's always on fucking live!
Yeah, exactly. Any other time, she's fine with them being alive. Now she's all kinds of pissed off because they're alive. Back in the other time, she's defending them that they're alive.
Is a vehicle pulling down here?
Kenisha, let me listen in the box.
Okay. Oh, shit. Sorry, I'm spacing out.
It's fine. I figured that.
Okay, so I did tell the police that the sister was being combative, or I told the ambulance or the dispatch, whoever I talked to. So they are going to come there, and they are going to be expecting someone being yelling.
Cops. Yep, they're driving by. Why'd they drive by instead of stopping?
I don't know.
I don't know.
I gave them the address that I had.
But Allie is not. She wasn't yelling at us.
They probably
were yelling at Jackie. Yes. And Jackie.
So you need someone.
She was talking about me, Kyle. I heard her.
She was talking about you yelling at Aunt Jackie.
And it's the cops.
Talking about me and Jackie.
Oh, man. Babe, you got to get downstairs.
Yeah, you need to go downstairs.
There's a whole shit ton of them.
She was yelling at Kenisha, Kyle.
That they were being, she was, being
she was yelling at me.
We're going out the back door. We're not going out the front.
That's fine. Do what you got to do, Kyle. Make sure you let them in.
Yeah, they need to see.
Go, go. Just go.
You guys need to come through the back door.
Yeah, I broke my
they won't let you through the front.
They won't let anyone through the front door. Back door too, so.
And I'm
and
sure they're going to be prepared.
I'm the one that called the ambulance for her. And because she... Huh? You guys live here? Yes. That's why I called the ambulance. Because she wasn't... She's been asleep for 23, 24 hours. Damn nail. Non-responsive. Yes. My mom both tend to be mother-in-law. My sister's bitching. Sorry if I'm cussing. I'm just highly pissed. But my sister's bitching about it. Wouldn't let me or the whole even up in the hole to see how she's doing. Don't like that.
Okay. Make sure you shut the door when you come in.
If something happened to him.
Do you guys have a balcony or something? Is that what you were on?
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah, they got a balcony outside their room. I believe that's where I believe that's where it's at anyways. Don't quote me on it.
Just letting you know the cops are here.
They are not allowed.
No, I'm just letting you know they're here.
They're going to come in.
Who you fucking called them?
I did it. I swear. You can check my call.
Who called them?
I did.
Who the fuck are you?
Somebody.
You need to stay the fuck out of my family business.
Well, I'm sorry when it's...
You don't see us going and barging in on your shit, do you? Stay the fuck out of our family
You gotta stop
business.
Yelling. My chest is racing out of my head. I'm gonna
you
go...
Tell her she needs to stay out of
I'm
it.
Gonna influence an anesthesia. You really gotta stop yelling.
She needs
Please.
To stay out of it. This is why I say do not be on TikTok around us. If you're gonna talk about family shit with us.
I
Because can't. This is why I don't wanna fucking have to deal with it. It puts
Maybe
me through a lot of hell.
Mother, then.
You do not fucking see how stressed I am right now. I have been trying to be nice. I have been trying this, but I can't fucking keep doing this. Because if you're gonna constantly be on TikTok, you're gonna be constantly on TikTok and them knowing everything about the family, there is no need for you to be down here while you're alive. I'm sorry to say that, but they don't need to know every fucking little thing that happens.
Well, I was the
life.
One that brought it on TikTok. It was Kyle, so yell at him.
Oh, trust me, I've dealt with his ass.
Now I got a pee. I've been trying to do. But pee.
Who is that? Is that? Who is that? Is that?
The sister.
Allie?
Yeah.
I'm gonna call someone else. Bitten.
Oh,
and so is Jackie. So, because your mom was asleep for almost 22 hours.
Just 1 minute.
When you're done going pee, you need to
get out of
here. The cops and let them in. No, the kid is at David's house.
No, the kid's at my house. That's my son here at my house.
Yes, Katie, you're correct. And I'm sorry, but when someone says that they haven't been woke up, moved, drank, or anything for 22 hours.
you donate.
In the comment section for purpose only. Don't want this account to get nannered. We need to keep spamming it.
You need to go let the cops come in. Whether
it's okay or not. Was that Allie screaming just then?
Yes, David, yes.
I'm perfectly fine. You hear her just fucking fine. She's talking and she's even
not when you're sleeping for almost 22 hours, Stacey. You're not.
No, I'm not sleeping.
Even your sister Jackie says you're not fine when you're sleeping that many hours at a time. Jackie even agrees with me on this.
Stops.
You go cry. You want at me. It's fine. I don't care. I can take it. I'm a big boy.
Go to the back.
I can't keep dealing with this shit.
Yep, you're right, Kylie. They don't have to at least talk to her.
It's always fucking with you because
I understand that, sis, but I was concerned, okay? I was concerned. And I have a right to be concerned.
Why does it seem like you're
I'm
not
living in the same county
as your mother? That's exactly what it seems like. You don't even give a shit.
My brother Damon.
Hey.
Stop.
Are you?
Yes. Okay. She didn't get up. She got to eat. So, done nothing today. She's a kid. I can't believe she's done. I've only been here 3 weeks. So.
And I've only been here 4. I've been trying before she came in to work on it. Like this. This will have a problem finding it. We'll try to get everything all good. It'll be like an
accident. We need some project. I got to do some. I'm just going to get y'all. I've been getting through that all day. I'm just gonna be the lowest fiance. No, they wouldn't let me. They wouldn't let me. The door. She's tripping on the top of everyone. She wouldn't get out of my side. I booked it my own. So, she needs to keep it low because that's. I'm coming here. I know. I don't.
That's fine, as long as we know that the cops are there.
Oh, you got it, okay.
I'm not going to make her worry about her service right now when she's talking to the cops. It's going to look silly.
Exactly.
I just don't want to do anything different.
scratches? Potato scratches?
Let's get them upstairs. Does your sister just not want him to come in the house because of the way the house looks?
I have no idea.
Is that like the big reason? Okay, I'm getting back out of the box now that they're there.
All right, Melissa.
Fidget?
No, I'm actually one of those. I took it back up to Chittix and I'll see if I can fix them.
Why? Why?
Hey, what's going on, Kenisha? Junior, quit yelling at the cars driving down the road. Quit yelling at the cars driving down the road. Go. What's the update? Are the cops still there?
Yes.
Junior?
What?
I want to ask you, Junior, how do you know they still are? Yes.
I'm just gonna stop saying things. Every time I say something, I get fucking yelled at. I'm done getting yelled at. Yeah, they left. She refused to go. She's going back to bed.
Of course she did.
I never said it was about me. Never once said it was about me. I can give a fuck less about myself. Stop caring long ass time.
I figured she refused to go to the doctor, go to the hospital. I already seen that coming. As soon as she woke up before they got there, I already seen that one coming.
I wasn't in the phone when they were talking to her, but I was telling the cop the situation.
But you got, like I said, you guys did the right thing. Yes, you guys. Maybe you guys should have done it hours ago. Yes, but at least you did call, and you got. They can be mad all they want, but her sleeping like that, like I said, you guys would have let her sleep and not done nothing at all, and something would have happened, and she would have passed away. And you guys did absolutely nothing to even try to wake her up or try to check on her or anything like that. You all three of you, you, Kyle, and Allie, could have very well been facing charges and going to jail. Plain and simple.
Well, I have proof that I went down there and tried to do something. I literally have proof that I've tried to do something. And I got yelled at for it.
I understand that. I understand that. But I understand that. I'm just saying, if you hadn't done nothing, if you hadn't called the police, if you hadn't called the EMTs and stuff, though, and she had, and something did happen, you guys could have very well traced charges. So by calling the police and calling EMTs out there, at least it covered you, your butts, and at least now we know she's okay. She's awake. I mean, she's not, obviously not okay, because she shouldn't be sleeping that long. Because she's got medicine she needs to take. Ain't she supposed to take medicine? Ain't she got medicine she's supposed to take every few hours or whatever it is, Kyle?
He's outside, but yes.
Morning, afternoon, and night. Ain't she medicine? Routine or something, like she on certain medicine you gotta take like every so often or whatever.
That's just to take her meds 3 times a day.
Okay, exactly. And with her sleeping like that, she's not taking them, and she's not taking them regularly, which can make it worse. Which would honestly, off.
The thing is, I'm trying. Everybody coming at me. I tried to take care of her, and I got fucking yelled at for it. She was in my fucking face, screaming at me.
With her sleeping like that, means she's not taking her medicine like she should, which means it's not helping her like it should, which is making her condition that much worse on her, which with her sleeping like that could very well cause her to pass away a lot sooner. And could actually make her pass away, which could
look bad on you guys. So like I said, there again, you guys did the right thing by calling like you did tonight. They made, yeah, Allie and her maybe pissed off, all kinds of pissed off at you. But you did the right thing. Like I said, Kyle, even your Aunt Jackie said the exact same thing. She even said you guys need to call.
Alarmed by the situation, vigilant viewers reach out to Adult Protective Services, prompting a visit to the house. However, tensions rise as the occupants of the house evade contact with APS by hiding when they knock on the door.
On September 19th, a tense atmosphere surrounds Kenisha, Kyle, and Allie as they embark on a cleaning mission within the home, aiming to complete the task before the anticipated return of Adult Protective Services in a few days.
Unfortunately, a good portion is not all the way down, so.
No, I know.
And it's just like the stairs. We didn't stop until we were all the way done.
I don't know if these boxers are cut. I don't know if these are yours or our brothers.
Those are not mine.
Okay, brothers then. No. And you're going to have to show them where the litter box is. Put them in the litter box.
They know where they are.
So they put them in. Well, they're not going to use them if they're not getting clean. That's why they're using it around it. And everywhere else. It's going to take a while for them to get readjusted since the litter box has been how it has been. For a while, it's going to take a while for them to get readjusted to using the litter box. And they're full-grown cats. So, if you see a mess...
Huh? If you see a tiny mess, you clean it up. Don't leave it on the floor and let it sit forever. What are you two doing? That's fine, because we're moving things around. This is Kyle's
mom's house.
Yeah, can't we crack a window? I might be able to breathe better. None of them have screens, and those ones won't shut properly out. They leak during the rain anyways. It's not raining.
It's been like this before I came here. It's been like this for a while.
Hi, Tink. What you doing?
Bad.
You doing back the yard? Trying to get out the door.
Your music's not working anymore. I'm gonna have to play.
Give me a little bit.
You can say I have an idea. Won't remember it all on my stuff. Cal, my phone's right there. Where are you going? You can't trust play on that.
On my phone? Yeah,
oh,
you can.
That phone is there.
Did A match it back?
Kenisha resurfaces after a brief break following the uncovering of the House of Horrors. On October 2nd, a cat urinates on Kyle's side of the bed, adding to the chaos.
Okay, so can I ask y'all a question, please? How do I get Chubbs to stop pissing on Kyle's side of the bed? I'm sorry, it's funny. I shouldn't laugh. Oh, Lord, have fucking mercy.
Hey, you two, stop!
Did you guys hear my question? Or am I lagging? I am not neutering him. He doesn't like Kyle, guys. It has proved it and proved it and proved it. He does not like Kyle. I know it's a territorial thing. Kyle is so fucking mad right now. I can't help but to fucking laugh. He looked directly at fucking Kyle, and I'm not even joking, just pissed. On his side of the bed. I'm sorry. Yeah, the cat peed on his side of the bed. He's been doing it for a while. He does not like Kyle. Does not like Kyle at all. He pissed on him, literally. I'll show you guys. Flip the camera, you'd see it better. Nope, he's pissing. It's only on his side of the bed, too.
Chubbs. Hi, boy.
You need to stop pissing on this side of the bed. The litter boxes are clean. That's the bad part. He's always pissing on Kyle's shit. Always.
Then, on October 5th, Kenisha retrieves the cats from her mom's house, causing a stir on Reddit.
The situation further unravels on October 6th, when it is revealed that Allie owes back child support for the children who were taken from their custody. Additionally, it is discovered that they have a total of 12 cats, with some kittens showing signs of blood in their stool. The house is overrun with kittens and being trampled wherever Kenisha walks.
Yeah.
Okay.
Sorry, Chubbs. Didn't mean to step on your foot, dude. Kittens are everywhere. Angel! Hey, I found Nessie!
Yeah, she's
following
me down
there. Come here, Nessie. Come here, Nessie! Stop running from me. Come here. What was the seventh one? Oh, Angel. I know, and I have a question for you guys. Jasper, and it's only Jasper because I've been checking because we left earlier because I had to go get my medication and we came back and there was blood. So I was waiting for them to use the litter box and Jasper has blood in his stool. I want to take him to the vet, but they think I'm overreacting. Everybody thinks I'm over fucking reacting. Does anybody know why an animal would have blood in their stool? I want to take them to a vet, but I plan on getting them their shots on the 1st. But well, I didn't see any worms. Just blood.
During a live stream, a viewer mentions their intention to retrieve the kittens from Kenisha.